I greet all of you. My name is John Ogunje. I represent Gigatech International. Thank you for another day like this. For the past few weeks now, we don't discuss on the issue that has to do with how to design and construct a center tab transformer. Something like this, center tab transformer. Before now, we don't try to define what the tape transformer means. We still tell you what are the parts of the transformer. We still also tell you how you will fit this macro. We don't still tell you also how you will fit calculate the power of your inverter transformer based on the core cross-sectional area. We have done that so far. But today, what we want to do has to deal with the things where you're supposed to know before you now set up inverter transformer where you want construct by yourself. What are these three things? Number one, for inside, load. Capacity. Number two, I will explain. Transformer losses. Number three, it can be transformer capacity. What did I take this one mean? I mean, the things where you want to connect for your transformer. Let's say the other day, when we were called the defined transformer, this is your center tap. If you can still remember, I said the source now they determine where the side of your transformer, whether this one are primary or secondary. So the side where they connect with the source, this one are your inverter now. Inverter. This is your center tap transformer. This is your iron core. And this is your output. So now the thing we want to connect for here, now that they call load. Let's just draw like this. Load. Call them load. Now this one be the load. Don't say that the I talk say now 13 volts night day here. Another 13 volts. This is the center tap transformer. And this one will come bring 240 volts. Now I come out here. This is the load. Center tap. Now here the plus pass enter. See the negative. You understand now?
The output.
So this thing they bring out 240 volts. Now I make this lamp. Let me can light so. Also see blender here. Let me can light. This one, let me load. This one and load. Correct. They consume energy. That energy where you consume, you can convert them to another form of energy. Like this one now, I connect them for here. See, you can bring light energy. This one now, I connect them, this blender, I connect them from here. It can roll mechanical energy. That force will take the road and will be mechanical energy. If you take and grind pepper, whatever you want to grind. So load, now waiting the plug for, where the plug for supply, where they consume current, where they consume energy, and it will convert that energy to another form of energy. You understand? Like your ceiling fan, now load, because it consume power. Look at this one now. This resistor. This one a resistor. Now load also. Because if you connect them for battery now, you can see consume current. Power go pass them. You understand? Look at another one. This one another component. This one they call a capacitor, electronic capacitor. See, this one another load. You understand? So load in general is a component or an electrical device that consumes energy. And then it will come convert them to another form of energy. You understand? That is the definition for load. It consumes energy and converts to another form. This one here. So as the current enter now, as the power enter, you understand? It will pass through here, then it will start to do whatever type of load will it be. Load in general, this load so, we get three types of load with respect to the waveform between current and voltage. We don't want to go to that place here. But I want to make you know, say three types of load there. Three types of load, electrical load. Three types of electrical electrical load. Eh? Number one there, that they call a resistive load. This resistive load, now something like this, iron. Eh? Candidate, a light bulb. That one will be like 200 watts. That one is with the red, if you plug on. That red holding this light bulb, what they see? Electric iron, heater. They are referred to as resistive load. You see, I have another one that they call capacitive load. Like this one now, na capacitor. You understand?
Capacitor
inside motor. Capacitor bank. You understand? Those are capacitive load. Then you have another one. You have inductive. Inductive. What is grammar? Too big, sir.
Yeah,
inductive load. Like your sleep fan. Your fridge. Those are coil. It did the back. Those ones are called inductive load. You understand? So you need to know the total capacity of this. You need to know the capacity, total capacity
so
of
that.
You will know the capacity of the transformer, inverter transformer, where you go do, where you go fit carry. For instance, if I say you want design inverter for maybe say two bedroom flat, let's say the light. The lighting point with day, let's say 80 watts. Fan, two ceiling fan, and 50 watts, two will give you 100. What again? Which other thing? TV, maybe now this energy saver, this thing that you get, television. This one, let's say 80. You understand? 80 watts. What other thing again? Others, let's say others. Let's say 100. So at the end of the day, you're going to have 160 plus 200, 360 watts. That will be the total load capacity where you want to design your inverter for. So you need to know this quantity. You need to know it. So now this one, now you go put for mine, where you go to design your transformer. Another thing, if now very high inductive load, like say now AC, or maybe a refrigerator, this one go fit carry on. Because that refrigerator now, the static current of a refrigerator is several times the running current. Because if you start them, or if you start AC or fridge, you will see the way it will drag the power. You understand? It will drag them. When it drag them, before it go on. So this one will go anywhere. So this 360 was just for this. This one we have mentioned. So light, fan, TV. I like this thing, we're not clear. TV, television, and others. So a total of 360 watts. So in this case, inverter will be two times the rating. Maybe like this one will be 630. It will carry on. Don't need to contest and just now. It will carry on. Don't be saying you want to design something, will be 360. Still go design inverter. Transformer will be 360. And you know, you're not good like that. You will let your transformer power big pass. The things we want to do. I don't have the second thing we want to discuss now. So number one, you should know the total load capacity. Have that in mind before you will peg and see the capacity, the size of the transformer we have. So
transformer losses.
Every transformer gets two losses with day. There's nothing you can do about it. That loss is there. There's a constant loss. There's a variable loss. Number one loss for there, number one there, now they be called iron loss. The iron loss, now this iron we will talk to, this magnetic core, it get two losses. Two losses we did here, one they call hysteresis loss, and another one, eddy current loss. 9 days for here. That is number one. Then the number two, another type of loss, that be the copper loss or the copper loss. I'm just calling it copper loss. That is the losses where they the windings. Whether not copper, it is one, whether not aluminium, the losses where they the windings. You know, say this one, if current they flow through wire. And because of the resistance way they inside the wire, there is bound to be heat. That heat where the wire tell you, if you touch this night, the hot. This wire now, if it is maximum, it will be hot. Now that will be the copper loss. You can only kind of control this, but this one is constant. This one they vary. So these are the two major laws which you need to compensate for if you design your transformer. These losses are there. So you need to compensate for it while you design your transformer. Number three, pause. Efficiency. You understand? Let's see that grammar still big. What it be transformer efficiency? Transformer efficiency now a measure. Maybe I put it that way. Is a measure of the output. Measure of the output to the input. In other words, is the ratio of the output power over the output. We thought that is say, yeah, we would be primary. So now it be the input. This side will be secondary, now it be the output. Now it be the output. You understand? So as I talked before, there are losses here. There are losses. Before you go feed produce, say like this 630 watts inverter or transformer, there are losses there which you need to compensate for. You understand? These losses now both copper loss and the iron losses. You need to add it to the input. You understand? Otherwise, if you just design it like that, the output where you will come out, you know, will reach this this value. Now this formula now will take calculate whatever you want to do, and this formula may you note and down. Transformer efficiency is equal to the output plus is equal to the output all over input plus efficiency is equal to the output. Efficiency of the transformer is equal to the output over the input plus losses. The losses there, iron loss and copper loss. 80%. Now I use for my efficiency. The time we had to design this one. 80% because of the losses we did. So how I take do that one? Just as we have said, when we use this formula. Efficiency now, my output where I want to get, where I designed to get now, 630 watts. You understand? So if this is my efficiency, it's going to be 80. Now percentage now, it's going to be 80 over 100. So you see, over, this is my output, and this one I get. Now I design. If you solve this one out, this one could be, say, the S, will not be come out. So that at the end, after you compensate for the losses, I still get 630 watts out of this transformer. So now, I hope you now understand though. I bet when they ask question, make it not too fast. If any area they wanna know, wanna not understand, wanna they ask, wanna they contribute, wanna see they can see encourage me. Like see this one now. You go see all these monsters they put. See, this the also you must the number the type of monster they go see what you go use. You still need to determine so that it will match this 630. They have to match. You need to calculate a monster. You go see another 3 monster they decide. See, 1, 2, 3, 90. A 3 day there. This one a fitter. See the main capacitor, then this one I push, what's it called? This one I drive. This one I push pull configuration. Let me be this one. This one's we never put the IC, so now for protection. I'm still working on the circuit. The back for here. No, sir. See where we did that generate the. So this one out there here would generate the square wave. Then this capacitor now would set the ROC circuit, would set the frequency of the square wave. This resistor and this capacitor now be the low pass filter. So that would try to modify modify square wave. You understand? This one now, if you pass through this resistor and capacitor and through this via this resistor, it don't come too low, so this one need to pick them up. It will raise them up before it will pass through these two autocoupler. This one's now autocoupler. You understand? To filter any other distortion with this design, so that at the end you will get a fairly or let's say modified square wave here. Modified square wave before it will go to the power amplifier where did that take place. So it's very simple. Because if you feel fit around well, remove all the dirty, this one not go hot. If you like, you use them for beginning the years, you go just do them, be like ice water. You know the hot. You understand? So we still have a long way to go. So please, don't take this thing very serious. If I too rush, anywhere I miss, or I mistake, you can still correct me. You understand? Moku go. Moku speeding everything up because the where we see the ghost still very far. So if you watch this thing for the first time, I better make you go subscribe. Press that subscribe button and the bell icon so that other video we will see produce, you will see the Siam. As I always say, life is a choice. So choose life, choose success, so that you and your household will live, as the Bible talk. So I agree with all of them. Thank you very much.